Burnscoe. Gous. The two Gouses in the Greef, I beg your pardon, Kyle Greef, the number eight, and then Stefan Greef, the lock forward. Meyer. And then the big left boot there. Dylan Lates had it very well covered. Put good positional play by the province right winger. Brought to ground there by Van der Westhuizen. Groom was a crisp service, but not the rhythm yet for Western Province, as Colby has to tidy up. You can always bet your life that Griquas will tackle and tackle really hard. Now a chance for some outlap. He's got great pace. On the inside is Groom. Now, oh, a foot in touch by Ciabella Sinatra. He just showed the pace. He's such an exciting runner. South African sevens player who's now come up into the 15-man game.
Yeah, what a pity there by a foot out by Sinatra. You know, I think the touch judge didn't want to chase him the whole way to the try line. He's really, really quick. So he was probably a bit relieved that he stepped on the touch line there.
So AJ Leroux with his first feed to the lineup. Such an important part of the game for hookers these days.
That's
a super take there by RJ Liebenbach. Then the little grovel forward by Griff. Meyer. Tester this for Sinatra. That could be out on the full and is. Now, there's a breeze that's got up here, Dave. And it's one of those things, you've played here in Kimberley, it's one of those things, very hard ground, normally blows a little bit across the field, but the flags are now fluttering quite strongly, and something the players have to adapt to.
Of course, and it's probably a factor in him kicking it directly out. I think that's going to be a strong point of the Griquas game. I think they're going to use their kicking tactics. They're going to try and pin the province into the corners and then obviously keep it tight with their forwards.
Groom under a little bit of pressure, but did well. Taken forward by Vilko Lowe, Groom, Katrakilis, Yaku Taute in that number 12 position. Of course, a couple of test players in the back line. Yaku Taute, Juan de Jong. Thomas
pulled him over. He didn't go off his feet.
Yuko Klopp is doing some really good work for Griquas. Worked out by Leroux. Sinatra just looking on the inside for Colby. We know how dangerous he can be. Nice little double back there on the boot away by close Prince.
Well, we can see the tactics of Griquas coming out there. They're going to try a kick to the corners. I think advantage them. There was a couple of kicking kicks backwards and forwards, but advantage Griquas at the moment.
So Bongi Mbanambi. It's very important that he gets his lineup throws accurate. One of the great advantages of hookers, if there's a choice between a hooker and they're both good in open play, the better thrower in the lineup will get the position. Well fielded by Gous. A lovely chance here for Griquas down that far side. A forward pass though to Donnie Minnie. Donnie Minnie was in full flight, the loose head prop forward.
Yeah, a real pity there was a slightly forward there. It would have been great to see the big front forward charging down the wing. And they don't get the opportunity often, Hugh, so when they get it, they want to be able to use it. And it's just a pity that the pass was slightly forward.
There's your line. Lungs. Stability.
Pack weights were quite an advantage for Western Province in the tight fire. The pack weight, but the front rows pretty even. It all goes down to technique. Kevel Mbanambi with Vilko Lowe. Groom with the feed. First scrum of the match for both sides, of course. Katrakilis, Tata, good line of running by De Jong.
Play on.
Katrakilis. Well, Province just probably aware that the Griquas guys are deadly tacklers on this hard ground. Groom, Carr, Kachakilis, Tauta, skips Colby and finds De Jong. Now Colby in possession and tidied up very quickly. Roger Liebenbach has been getting around the park there, the man with his hands on his head.
Yeah, one or two mistakes creeping in from Province, but I think it's just cobwebs coming out. They haven't played a lot, obviously. They haven't had that much, well, they haven't had many warm-up games together. It is going to be a bit scrappy for them in the beginning, but I think there's some exciting players, and you can see it's starting to come together. I think we could be in for an exciting afternoon.
Okay. Square up. All two for Nila. Message for both of you, him and him.
Mini LaRue and Van der Beer stays in that front row for Griquas.
Nice and square.
Yep. Let's work. Aye, aye.
Say, coach. On.
Groups.
Yes.
Ole. Let's go. Okay.
Van der Vesthuizen on the tight head side. Mini and LaRue.
Set.
Groom, Kachakilis. Lates was a dummy runner, but the Griquas defenders read it very well onto Tata. Heavily tackled. It was great defense by Griquas there. They didn't take the dummy runner. Worked away there by Klein. Chance on for Colby. Good play into the Griquas 22 by Western Province. And Arco has cleared out well. Colby at half back. Now Kebble. You can see the aggressive tackling of the Griquas. Kachakilis. Province still on an advantage. Now it's Elstad.
Release.
Making his comeback. Good to see Reinhardt Elstad. All those people in Montague will be sitting forward in the seat. Now Colby. Sinatra. Little dodge here. Little dart there. Up to the 5 meter line. Kachakilis at scrum half. Now Carr. Nizam Carr breaks through the defense.
Great passage of play there by Western Province, pulling the phases, dragging the defenders in, and Nizam Carr bursting through, using all his strength. Not so sure about the tackle being great, but bursting through and scoring a great try. The opener for Western Province. Yeah, great work by Sinatla, staying in touch. So to tell all youngsters, stay inside, do not run out, unless you're going for the corner. And then the ball here, the dummy runner, and to Nizam Carr breaking through the tackle, head down. And under the poles.
See an 86% success rate. Top scorer in the Currie Cup last year with 123 points. And he begins his campaign of 2015.
This is just the tail end of that move, you know, really good build-up by Province, and the Bishop's boy scoring under the poles, Nizam Carr.
Fillion. Kachakilis, Groom. Position for Griquas, and that's a clever move, and that's a terrific running. Great move there involving Arendsad and Liebenbach gets it away for Lune. Great attacking position for Griquas. They've upped the pace here. Have Griquas and the Province under the whip. So they'll go back for the penalty. A little bit of pushing and shoving going on. Now, is that the try given? I'm just having a look at... Yeah, Yaku Pepa has awarded the try. I thought he'd award the penalty because he walked away immediately. And so it looks like AJ LaRue is the man who gives thanks to the heavens.
Well, as any good team will, Pugh, they'll strike back immediately. And Griquas did just that. There was a fantastic move off the back of the lineup, caught Province unawares. And as a good team will do, they came in their droves and they used the ball wisely and managed to score. So a great comeback by Griquas.
Conversion by Coast Prince Lua. Well taken by Darren Sapp. This is a Michael van der Spey, charged down, taken by Tata.
For him. Have you ever spun rocks at all? Accidental.
Accidental offside, judged by Yaku Pepa. Accidental offside, of course, results in a scrum.
Yeah, just a little bit lazy and a bit lateral from Griquas. Probably still celebrating the try. They need to get the basics right and make sure they get out of their 22 from the restart.
Happy with that. Just a slush. Just a slush.
Discipline. Set.
No, it's a power scrum by Western Province. So the front rows, I'm just looking for them. Normally there would be a whole lot of high five in, but calmness in the Western Province front five there. So it should be a pretty easy attempt for Dimitri Katrikilis.
A good scrum out by Province. You know, this is the forwards obviously haven't paid a lot together. It's the background we know everything about. But a fantastic scrum here, right under the posts of Griquas, and an easy penalty for Katrikilis coming up.
Well, we talk about easy penalties. The entire Province side have gone back towards the halfway line. There isn't a chaser in sight. As I always say, sometimes you can scrap it and it can hit the crossbar or the upright or something. They have full confidence in their kicker. Only De Jong sort of hovers, no problem.
The experience of De Jong staying up there with his kicker, just ensuring that, you know, that didn't happen. If there wasn't a bounce off the poles, but it is a kick that he should kick 10 times out of 10.
Tauta. Groom. Katsikilis. And Tion Mayer is a little over eager. Wanted to put the pressure on the Western Province fly half. Well picked up by Yaku Pepa.
That's the kind of thing Griquas are going to do. They're going to flirt to the offside lines. They're going to try and get in under the skin of Province. We spoke about it. You know, no big team wants to come to Griquas. It's a tough outing. And so they're going to try and get under their skins and unsettle them. Province are not looking like that at the moment. They're looking very strong. And they're starting to... It's going to be a long afternoon for Griquas if Province start to get this right.
Well, it was a super kick by that man there. We hear he's going to Montpellier at the end of the ABSA Currie Cup. Shortened line out called by Western Province. The two locks, Klein and Huerta there. Goes for Huerta. Groom tidies nicely. Now Elstadt charges over the 22. Groom. Whoa, a beautiful little dummy. Very nearly through. Good defense there by Van der Vestes and the tight head prop.
Release.
Now, Kachakilis can get those rapid backs on the move. Tauta. Good step in by the inside center. Groom, they're keeping up the pressure. Mbanambi. Desperate defense by Griquas. Now they're lining up. Notch is there. He receives. Groom, Katrakilis, Colby. Strong defense. Meyer did very well to stop Ches and Colby there. Groom still working the short side. Dylan Lates.
Your penalty.
Side entry.
Free ball.
I think it was Nizam Carr who entered the side of the, well, it was a maul because the ball hadn't gone to ground.
A pity because a good passage of play there by Western Province. Nick Groom instrumental in a couple of sniping breaks around the scrum and set up an opportunity for Western Province, which is a pity about the mistake at the end.
Well, we've had 17 minutes in the game and Griquas have had to make 28 tackles, of which they missed three. Western Province so far have only had to make seven tackles, yet to miss one. Problem when you overcomplicate. I believe you've just overcomplicated a bit and then overthrow. Elstadt, lovely ball for Dimitri Kachakilis and well read by Tauta. Sinatra, now the chase is on. Sinatra, whoa, did he get it? If he did, it will be a magnificent piece of finishing by the province left wing.
Well, I had the privilege of seeing Sinatla in Dubai for the Sevens, and he was just electric. And this is fantastic bit of skill by him. And we'll have to obviously wait and just see what the TMO says about whether he grounded it. But fantastic bit of skill nonetheless.
JJ Wagner, the TMO. That is an absolutely brilliant finish.
Well, we're in the first game of the Currie Cup, and I think that could be one of the tries of the season. It was a genuine bit of individual brilliance by Sinatla, and the handling skills, I mean, it's a rugby ball, and to be able to pick it up like that, I think that's fantastic. You see him coming from outside the field, so hopefully he's managed to keep his... See, he's in there.
What did he have his foot in touch when he grabbed the ball?
Well, that's what we've got to see, whether he had the ball.
Could be a very, very good decision by the TMO. It's as he grabs the ball, have a look at his left leg. He was certainly infield when he scored. He grabs the ball now, watch his left leg on the line. Brilliant TMO.
It is a real pity. That was a fantastic bit of skill, but I think you're right. The TMO is going to call this and say his foot was in touch when he was touching the ball.
Watch the left leg, he grabs the ball, he's in touch.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he's touching the ball there, Hugh. I'm going to have to take that back about one of the tries of the season. It was almost one of the tries of the season.
Well, the players have seen it, and they're all walking up to the 5-meter line.
When he carried the ball, his foot was in touch.
Okay, so he actually took possession of the ball whilst his foot was in touch.
That's correct, yes.
Touchline. Okay. In touch. Foot on touchline.
Well, the great advantages of modern technology. In the old days, that may well have been adjudged a try. So, a vital defensive line out for Griquas. They've missed one. Kloppers has done well. Mayer away for...
He stepped in after the throw. That's fine.
Nardis van der Vault. Mayer, Viljoen. Well, Rian Viljoen is one of those few players who still torpedoes the ball. There's no question you gain more distance from a torpedo than an end-over end kick.
Fafu de Toy used to do that on this very same ground, and he used to kick it from in his own dead ball area, and it would go out in the opposition 22. It used to really, the heads of the forwards of the opposition used to drop, because it was just, how do you counter that?
Klein, Groom, Notche.
Didn't survive. Ball out. Ball out.
It was good defense there by AJ LaRue, the Griquas hooker. He got onto Groom very quickly. Groom now finds a Colby. Kibble. Barging run by Ali Kibble. Now De Jong. Elusive runners. They've got these beautiful elusive Sinatra. They've got these wonderful elusive runners, and then the bulldozing effect of Oddy Kebble.
Well, that was fantastic skill by Western Province, started by Oddy Kebble, then some fantastic hands by Jean de Jong, and Sinatra finally getting in for the try that he almost had a few minutes ago. I mean, this is a bullocking run, as you can see, smashing over a couple of players, and then still having the skill to get the ball away to de Jong. De Jong keeping it, getting his hands free as well, and Sinatra finishing off what is a brilliant try for Western Province.
Advantage because the wind has dropped again. And no problem for the machine like Kachakilis.
Well, let's watch this again. Fantastic skills. That's what I've been talking about. They're trying to get the hands through the tackle, and you know, just like the New Zealanders do. Maybe that's the influence of John Dobson, you know, ensuring that the players utilize all their skills and try and get the passes away and finish off opportunities that they create.
Another great kickoff by Viljoen, gathered by Kachakilis, away quickly to Groom. Much better touch finder by the scrum half this time.
I always feel sorry for a scrum half in a situation like this. I mean, like I said, the Griquas are going to be flirting with the offside lines and putting pressure on the scrum half, and it becomes scrappy for him. But I think he's doing very well under the pressure he's being put under.
Kane is overthrown, beautifully gathered there by Buerta. You see how they get onto the front foot to Province as a result of the mix-up in the line. Tata, late, not a bad little jab, it's on the bounce. No, well covered there by van der Spey. Michael van der Spey did very well to get back there and call the mark as he caught it.
They can charge as a free kick. Yeah.
Well played by the Griquas number 12.
Yeah, the backs of the province really looking exciting this afternoon. Every time they touch the ball, they look like they're going to score. Another little tap by Dylan Lates to keep the ball inside, but great defense by Griquas.
Efficient by Buerta.
Stay in.
Oh, the Moors on the go here with Nizam Khan.
Use it once.
Griquas have to be careful of a side entry. Now here goes Carl. Has he got the pace, the power? Prince did well to temporarily stop him, and they've won the penalty.
Leave him,
quickly
leave him.
Taken by Funnis Bay. Leave him, and they didn't. Now the referee is going to call up. Is he going to? Yeah, he's digging in his pocket.
Listen, he's not even close to 10 meters. I shouted, leave him.
Shouted twice, leave him, leave him. And so it is a problem here. Jean Klein.
Cynical within 10.
The referee did shout twice, leave him, leave him. They didn't obey, they paid the price. Now let's see, watch for the torpedo here. Bang, there it goes. Super kick by Fillion.
Now Nizam Khan was almost too good here. Yeah, and professional foul, and that's what's going to happen. You know, Griquas have got to take advantage of, because the province machine was starting to rumble. And they were looking dangerous. Griquas have got to take advantage now of the 14 men.
Well, Griquas have lost two of their own lineouts, so they've got to. That's better. Khriyev.
No.
Oh, and Ron Burch, I thought he was away there. All 2 meters of him. Well, the next game is the Pumas against the Sharks. 17:45.
Square.
That's in Nelspruit. Tomorrow the Kings take on the Golden Lions in Port Elizabeth. And then Free State are in Bloemfontein against the Blue Bulls. The championship tomorrow morning at 11:30. That's also for the Bledisloe Cup, Australia against New Zealand. And then the local test match at 16:15.
Fine. Sit. Good drum.
Cliff, Maya, Fillion. Good defense by Katrakilis. Good front football for Maya. Now it's with the Thunderbolt, not as Thunderbolt.
Lost it. All out, play.
Liebenberg.
Play on.
The boot by De Jong.
What was that?
Dukisa has work to do here. Very nearly got to his feet. Now he's got to release the ball. Fillion is there, didn't release. You can see Yaku Paper there. Quickly taken there by Sinatra. Groom, beautiful by Notcher. And Dylan Lates will canter in for Province's third try. A lot of Western Province supporters. There they are, the Western Province supporters here in Kimberley.
I think that was good, quick thinking by Sinatla, I think it was. Now keeping the ball alive, quick tap penalty, catching Griquas unawares. They had a massive overlap, and he gave an easy try to Dylan Lates.
They're vital factors in a game of rugby, and one of them is the pass of Notche. When he got the ball, his timing was absolutely perfect. Sometimes it is a little factor in rugby that really makes a big difference in terms of a try opening up for the likes of Dylan Lates. Dimitri Katrakilis is receiving a little bit of attention.
You're absolutely right, Hugh. I mean, it's the little things that people don't necessarily see. It's the quick hands. Yes, they had a big overlap, but it was the quick hands, because the defense rushed up, the few that they had rushed up on them, and they managed to get the ball away, and it made it look easy in the end. But there were some very good skills there in the back line.
Thank you. Four out of four for Katrakilis. Now watch, that's the pass I was talking about. Notchi, vital that he catches and passes within half a pace. Makes all the difference in the movement.
And that's forwards playing like backs. That's what we want to see, Hugh, for the skill levels of the forwards. It's fantastic to see.
Well, a bit of a torpedo drop kick there from Falun. Lates with the clearance. Post Prinsville indicating he's going to do that. Katrakilis has had to commit, does well, covered by his opposite number.
Ball's available.
Groom, Carvey, De Jong. Carr. Stopped there by Funnevolt, who's defending for his life. 40 tackles now made by Griquas, only 12 by Western Province. Oh, now this is interesting. Well taken by Karel Grief. Van der Spey. Went for the outside, covered there by Tauta, and good tackle by Dylan Lates.
No. One go, not two.
Remember, Western Province down to 14 men still.
Yeah, and the penalty there, as you heard the ref say, that Mzamkar was the second person to arrive, and he's not allowed to put his hands in. It was only the first tackler is allowed to put his hands in.
Yeah, okay.
First to arrive, should I say, is Huey. You can see De Jong, he has every right to go for that ball, and I thought that they were going to steal the ball there. But then you see Nizam Kar comes in from the side and illegally so.
Griquas have been on the back foot for a while, so it's absolutely vital that they win a good line-out ball here. Toppers go, it's overthrown again. That's a real problem. Well recovered there by Donny Mini. Meyer. Mini goes again. Catch it with Van der Westhuizen, who was the first runner. The tight head prop, then the loose head prop. And a sad end to the move for Griquas.
Yeah, but good defense there by Province. Now with 14 men, they're throwing their bodies on, putting their bodies on the line and defending brilliantly for a team with 24-7 up. They're still defending their line with everything that they have, and it's great to see.
Blood on the cheek of the former St. John's boy.
Maxi medal. Yes, off.
Good tack by Buerta. They've worked well. The two Western Province locks at line out time. Notch here at the back in the possession. Groom. Saw the opening, Sinatra, Groom. Well read there by Aronson. He did well on defense, and Katrakilis as well for Tauta. Lovely ball for Colby. Problems here for Grick was all. He held on a step too long, did Cheslin Colby that time. Normally his timing is superb, but one step too far. Late should have got it, a step earlier.
Yeah, but let's not give him too hard a time there, Huey. I think he was caught between two minds. You know, I think he was the dummy was on. There was no one inside this player. And then at the last minute, I thought to rather get the ball away. Just not to give him too hard a time for it. He's a brilliant player.
Stevie, come on, right after your rug, so kijk je vie.
Coming.
Hey, Volkan. Hey, Volkan.
Check the square. Hip square.
Squat.
Seconds.
Hip square. As I Hanos. Crouch.
Set.
Bind. Set.
Charge away there by Karo Kriev and sees off one defender. Good play by the number eight. Mayer.
Play on.
Fillion. Mayer, beautiful covery. It will follow up by Mayer. And on the right wing is Aarons, but we've got a man and ball at the same time.
Well, not necessarily the right option there. I think it was a kind of hope and a prayer of a pass there. I think they should have straightened it up, brought the province defenders in, and then set up and gone again. They are down to 14. There are going to be gaps in the defense, and I think they just need to be a little bit more patient.
Let's go. Have you got here? Have you got here?
Again, it's efficient between thrower and jumper.
Yep.
Once again, it's Notchi in the van. You see, he's taken over from Clark. His car's moved into the lock position. Groom, Katrakilis.
Instruction there. Going back, side entry, two.
Side entry by AJ Leroux. Now, interesting, they will be looking for a bonus point for Western Province. They've got another 46 minutes to do so.
I'll check now. How much time for the yellow card, please? Next time the play goes there. Next time, yeah. Okay, 3 points.
Interesting bit of captaincy by Juan de Jong there. He knows he's got seven men in the mall. This was a pretty good mall by Western Province with their seven men, but Juan de Jong quite obviously decided, okay, we've got seven men. You heard him say quite clearly to the referee, how much time for the yellow card? Too much time, Dimitri kick for goal. Interesting captaincy.
No, it was a good experience there. And I think what the ref said was next time that the ball goes dead, he can come back on. So they're obviously going to take up a bit of time here, go for poles, take the 3 points if possible, and get their man back on the field.
Well, an unusual miss for the province fly half. Fillion.
Terug van wet af.
Now, chance again for them to get going. Notches had a good first 40 minutes. Katrakilis, Tauta. Prince Lua. Ooh, and some result of that is that province now had the throw into the lineout, so they may well get their maul going for the fourth try.
I wasn't necessarily in agreement with Yakutada's choice or option there, but it actually turned out to be a brilliant kick. Forced the Griquas player to have to play it, and then they tackled him out. Advantage, Stormers. Well, Western Province, should I say.
Clear timing.
Well, interesting. You see number five there. Okay, he's now moved into the line-out. Has Ruan Buerta. And up he goes, uncontested.
More.
Now, can they move the maul? Will they move the slight weight of the maul? Desperate stuff by the men in peacock blue. Grimm will have to release it. Late Kachakilas, beautiful ball for Colby Sinatra. Just a little too far in front of him.
Option.
His first mistake of the afternoon, but again, something maybe out of camera that people didn't see was the brilliant pass by Dimitri Kachakilis that sliced over the defense there, went right over the defense of Griquas and set up the opportunity. Just a pity they couldn't finish it.
Well, quite interesting. From that, you see he's knocked on there, and then the ball goes into touch. So now the referee said option. You now have an option of either a scrum or a line out, which you didn't have in the old days. Would have been a scrum without the option of a line out. In that field position, better to take the more solid scrum. And the line outs have not been brilliant for Griquas.
Crouch. Fine. Set. Behind the ball.
Good scrum by Griquas. You see them putting the pressure on. It's a very good defensive scrum by the home team. They're trying to milk the penalty here. Mayer and then the front of Spade. And they did. They won the penalty, so it's a great one scrum
in.
By
stay in.
The defensive team.
Not staying square.
As you said, Hugh, a great work by Griquas, forcing the penalty and able to get themselves out of the danger area.
So Michael van der Spey, because of his powerful left boot down that right touchline.
So there was a discussion the other night here with a good friend of mine, Vince McLean. He was telling me that the tight head is the most important person in the pack, and he was explaining to you why. So we're going to get let's give it to Ewald van der Vestas for that scrum.
Now it's important. They've overthrown a couple here, have Griquas, and that's good for Liebenbach. Mayer, this is now what Mini Finn's line very flat, so Mayer does that. Sinatra under pressure coming from Aaron Sapp.
Play on. Or back.
Finn forward, LaRue. Mayer, Finn Liebenbach. Comes for the Griquas skipper again. Fillion. Well, they're trying to crash through a Griquas and they making no headway under this very solid defense of Western Province, renowned for their great defending both in Super Rugby and ABSA Curry Cup. Kachakilis can't kick it out but does because it's half time. So it's been a successful half for Western Province, and Benny Nokia will be down on the field chatting to Rian Fillion.
Rian, tough first half. Western Province defense is solid. Any plans, any changes in your tactics?
No, I think we just need to get a ball, hands on the ball. We've been defending for 40 minutes, so you can't play rugby like that all day.
And then are you not deciding maybe to put it more in the corners, or that back three quite dangerous?
No, we want to put it in corners, we just don't get ball. So as soon as we get ball, we can do our game plan and force it on Western Province.
Well, I hope you get the hands on the ball for that second half so we get you back in the game.